it's quite a bit colder down here today. But anyway, nonetheless, first one out, and could that well be a coin, I think. Hard to tell, but it's a lot easier today to be able to film stuff while the sun's not shining through the viewfinder. It's not easy doing a bit of filming while the sun's shining. Oh well, another grotty copper thing, but it's the first egg and all for today, so ain't gonna grumble. Gonna bag it and on to the next. Nice one. Much better here today. Cool. Do you know what, the last couple of weeks, by this time, it's been ridiculous temperatures, sweating conkers, losing the love for carrying on, but it's nice and cool here today. But here we go. What's this one then? Ooh. That to me looks like a ring. Let's have a look at you. Yep, that looks like a ring to me. Sweet! That's my first ring. A la carte. I'm liking that. Fantastic. Post that up for an ID straight away. That's brilliant. I'm loving that. Excellent. Let's post that up. Onwards and upwards. On to the next. Hopefully plenty more. Meanwhile, there's Gary, look. Yes. Having a munch. Gary! You found me at last. You gonna jump in? Have a walk around? Hey? No? More interested in the plants, yeah? Alright, mate. I do believe I have just spotted a little deer. Just there, look. Sign of movement, but don't want to scare him off either. But yeah, there is. Oh, there is some movement. It's not a horse, for God's sake. Sorry, me and my sound effects. Cool. See if I can get a bit closer and get a close up. Thought I did to 50p, but it's not a 50p, is it? Too thin. And just there, look. Not sure if the camera's zooming in on that, suggests it might be a button. But yeah, I don't know. Very thin, look. Tiny wafer thin. They're gonna pass that by. Nice one. Lovely jubbly. On to the next. Yeah, it was definitely two now. Not that far away. I'm only about 20 meters away in there. Curious things, aren't they? hopefully they're going to let me get a little bit closer without tearing off. Gotta love being in the country, ain't you, with wildlife like this. Fantastic stuff. Cool. Another signal. Now, could that be another coin? Nah, button. Humongous button again. Oh, I wonder what they were used for doing up or holding up or... Wow. Still, one for the button collection. On to the next. Close it again now, and I am really not that far away, but they really don't seem that bothered that I'm here. It's just so cool. And things. Hello. As if it's going to talk back to me. Yeah, he's curious, all right. Amazing things, though. Whew. And another one. Just down there somewhere. There it is. So it's dark in there. What is that then? No idea. Tell. That's one for cleaning up when we get home, hopefully. But, yeah, I just can't see anything on there whatsoever. But still, that's what I like to see. Something else from the ground. On to the next. I think I'm in their comfort zone now. Every couple of feet I get closer, they're not happy. Oh, bless them. Hopefully they'll come back. I think I've scared the little deers off now. But hopefully they'll come back. I know I said I'm not one for giving up a buckle, but the size of this bugger, that is ridiculous. The size of that. Humongous. Be interesting to see what that's like when it's got all the mud and everything off it and... Yeah. Yep. Ain't gonna pass that one up. Lovely jubbly. On to the next. Deer have long run off now, but never mind. Amazing things to look at. There was three of them together at the end. I thought it was just the one at the beginning. But anyway, we got signals. So, back to it. Coin. George V? Yeah. George V shilling. Lovely, I'm not going to give that up. It's nice, see if I can get a date on that. 1929. Fantastic. Lovely jubbly. Right, on to the next. I think we've got ourselves a bit of a spillage. That's the hole that I literally just dug with the Georgia 5th shilling in, literally just now. And just next to it, whatever this is. Let's have a look at you. Could be another, yeah, it's another Georgia 5th. Not quite sure what though. Oh, damn. Oh, what have we got here? Is that florin? Is that what it says on the bottom? Yep, florin. And just trying to establish a date on there somewhere. Not sure if I can find one. There we go. The date is just along there, 1930. One florin. It's the first one I found, and I'm certainly not going to reject that. A la carte. Lovely jubbly. Not even 5 feet away from the florin and the sixpence. It's another signal, another coin, and that is way too gone to try and figure out what that is. And in the first video I did of detecting on this particular permission down in Glastonbury, I took a toothbrush to a coin like this and absolutely destroyed it. Shame really, haven't got a clue what it is, but it's a find. Lovely jubbly. This is quite a tight area, lots of signals coming out of this one. On to the next. Warming up a bit now. Wow, it's getting warm. And this is really curious kind of thing. It's kind of like a I don't know. It's a weight of some description by the looks of it. Not seen anything like that before. But fair weight to it, and something different. Not found anything like that before, so nice one. Lovely jubbly. On to the next. I think I've dug this one out. Yeah, I think I've dug it out. Sun's coming out now, so it's getting hard to see what's on the thing. What's that? Oh. What is that? Is that a weight? Not sure what that is, but I think that might be a weight, but one to post up anyway, and loving it. Excellent, on to the next. Pretty annoying getting these things. I keep thinking they're coins, but they're those humongous sized buttons, and like I said earlier, God knows what they held up. Some incredible pair of dungarees. But I ain't complaining about it. Lovely condition, and it's a keeper. on to the next. Again, I'm not one to pass up a nice buckle, but there you go. Sunshine. Nice little bit of detail on that as well. That lovely. This one definitely to clean up when I get home. Fantastic. Plenty of time yet. On to the next. You know when you have those moments where you got a target and you just can't find it in the hole, and you're digging deeper and deeper and deeper, but it's worth it in the end. I just dug this little baby out, and that is gorgeous. Fantastic. Not kind of sure exactly what it is yet, but it's very delicate. You can see a crack in it just around there, look. And I am going to try very, very hard but very carefully to clean that up when I get home. And I'm chuffed to bits with that. That is bloody fantastic. A la carte. Wonderful. It's a keeper, and this is what I love about this hobby. You just dig in the unknown all the time. Fantastic. Excellent. On to the next. Sun is absolutely baking now, and it started off quite a cool day, but signals are still coming thick and fast, and this is probably another one of those mutant button things I've been finding. But let them look. Oh, I don't know. No, it doesn't look to be a little button thing on there. But it's a grey day, what you call it, coin. Grey day naked. But anyway, it's a find, and that's what I like. Plenty of time yet. On to the next. Hungry. Hungry? Hello. What's this then? What's this? What's this? What's this then? Hey? Where are you cuties? Aren't you? You're cute. We're back down to Glastonbury permission this morning, and just gone 6:10. The weather's not looking too promising today. We've been forecast storms, and the wind is just about picking up, so not kind of sure what kind of a day it's going to turn out to be just yet. But nonetheless, I'll enjoy it. Got me waterproofs. Got a nice woolly hat, so my head will be nice and warm. But meanwhile, going to enjoy me tea and watch some telly in the car. Yeah, that's me sorted for the next 20 minutes. And then we'll get kitted up and booted up and ready to go. Fingers crossed, though, the weather will hold off a bit. Because the sky looks nice and clean over there. It's drifting off that way. It has been raining on the drive down, but anyway, shall see you shortly. Well, the farmers out here, or the farm hands, they like their snuff. This is the second one I've found now. I found one about 2 weeks ago in a different field. Same brand, same. Exactly the same kind of snuff from the same place, but a much smaller tin. But yeah, I like a tin like that. Shame there's none in there, Got a bit of a runny nose today, but there we go. Onwards and upwards. I'm liking that. Yeah, weather's definitely getting... wind's picking up quite strong now. So hopefully it's not going to interfere too much with the mic, because I haven't got one of those furry hamster things on the phone. Not as yet. But there you go. Next find. Looks like a penknife. Yeah. Ringing out at 68 to about 70. Double ringer. That'll do. It's a nice little find. On to the next. Another quick find. And what a strange contraption that is. How strange. I don't know, off a watering can or something stupid like that. Who knows? But anyway, that's what it was. Oh, the wind. There's another one of those, what they call them, those ox things. I forget what they told me they were now. I thought they were bottle tops, and they were what you put on the horns of horned cattle. Different size to the other two I found, but it's a keeper. Excellent, on to the next. Well, I think Michael Fish got it right today. But at least the Met did anyway, the Met office. They did say that around about lunchtime we were going to have some really strong winds. Winds have really picked up now, and yeah, the rain's come. But having fun, and my wife tried to put me off from coming here today because it is quite a journey. It takes about 2 hours to drive here, 2 hours back. Hey, I'm out here having fun. I don't know what she's doing, probably housework, but I'm out here in the pouring rain, in the wind, having a laugh, having fun, getting soaked, getting windswept, but I'm finding things, and I'm finding some wonderful things, and yeah, nothing beats that feeling. So couldn't really care less what the weather's doing. I'm having fun, and best thing about it is I've got about another 6 hours left yet, so a la carte, that's what I like. Fantastic. Catch you guys later. It's a nice easy signal. At least it's not a button this time. It's nice, and you can see a Britannia on there. There you go. You can see a date. Can we see a date? No, not such. And a bust. Okay, that looks like a Vicky. So, Vicky Halfpenny maybe. Can't see a date off the top of my head. Let's give it a quick lick. I don't think that helped. No, I can't see it. But still, nice. Nice to get a coin that's got some recognition on it. So, lovely. On to the next. Well, it happens. That would have been a really nice little buckle once it's cleaned up. But inevitably, yeah, just a little too much tension trying to get it out, and it snapped. But it happens. But I do love a buckle, and I'm sure that would have been a nice one. But anyway, not to worry, on to the next. So much easier being able to film today with no sun and not having to wear sunglasses, because the holes are being really dark and deep and can't see nothing at all. But today, overcast, drizzling. But anyway, here's a strange one. Just down there, look. That is strange. Really not sure what that might be. How odd. Not sure if those are intended markings there. Is that potentially a game piece or something? And very unusual. Might take a picture of that and post that up actually. Really unusual. The way I'm looking at this, that actually looks like a face. There. Little mouth, little chin, little eyes. I don't know. It's pretty square on flat at the bottom as well. Who knows? One to post up and let's see what people think. Excellent, on with the next. Another find, and I'm really not having a great deal of luck with buckles today. There we go, look. That would have been, sorry, let's just get me balance. That would have been a nice buckle. But alas, it looks like something's missing at the middle. But shame really. But there you go, that's the nature of the hobby. You don't always pull stuff out the ground as it was made. I suppose you find it as it was intended to be found. Rusty and knackered. But anyway, I ain't going to argue about that. That would have been a nice buckle. Excellent. Tidy. On the next. Typical sun's coming out now, and it is absolutely sweltering. I was just getting used to the wind and the rain and the nice cool temperature. But hey ho, never mind. Another signal, and there she is down there. Okay, coin. Again, the sun's shining through the viewfinder, and when that happens, I just can't see anything at all. So I'm not kind of sure what that is yet. Let's just give it a quick clean up and come back to you now. Okay, tried to give it a quick clean, but it's probably the best I'm going to get it at the moment until I can soak it properly and have another gander. But just around the edge, look, I'm wondering if it is a coin or not. There's quite a fine edge and a lip going around the outside all the way. Not sure if you guys can see that, but other side is pretty smooth. I'm intrigued by that. And it's that outer little rim that's kind of making me curious, but anyway, we'll have a look when we get back. On to the next. Apologies in advance for the wind noise. Got me hand over the mic just in case it sounds like it's blowing a gale, which it is. You can see by the grass, it's unusual weather to say the least. Last week, I found one of these, and this one is roughly the same kind of size, again completely flat bottomed. Looks like there was a loop going through that. I initially thought it was a fishing weight or something like that, but what would a fishing weight be doing right out in the middle of the countryside? No idea, but it's a weight. Second one I found. I love them. Tell some kind of a story. Wish I really knew what they were, but hopefully somebody will post up in the comments and be able to identify it. But for now, I'm just going to call it a weight of some description. Excellent. On to the next. Okay, another find, and majority of these finds today have been quite deep. I mean, the pinpointer is in there with probably about an inch over. I don't know how long that is. What is it, a foot? Something like that. But, yeah. But, it's pulling out great signals. And, straight out, another coin. I'm not kind of sure what this is. Look. Oh, it's left a nice bit of crusty green. I can see a lot more through the viewfinder today in the lack of sunshine, but it is raining slightly, which doesn't help. To believe, look, there's a, is that a date on the bottom of there? Get it to focus in. You guys can probably see that before I can, actually. Let's give it a quick clean, see what we can find. Be back now. No, I'm not going to risk, certainly not going to risk cleaning that one. That looks like it's, looking at it through the viewfinder, that it's quite an old Britannia on the obverse side. Sorry, on the reverse side, on the obverse side. Can't quite make that out. Really can't. Give that one a soak, I think, and see if I can get it cleaned up. But nice. It's a keeper, that's what I like. There's been quite a few different coins that have come out today. This one's intriguing as well, so looking forward to cleaning that up. Okay, on to the next. Now I've put my waterproofs on and now the bleeding sun's coming out. Typical, typical. Anyway, regardless, the signals are still coming. And you know me by now. Not one to pass up a buckle. A shame I snapped the one earlier on, because that looked like it could have been quite a nice decorative button buckle. But yeah, a buckle's a buckle. I'll take that. And nothing wrong with that at all. Fantastic. Lovely. Right, plenty of time yet. Onwards and upwards, on to the next. Still raining. Still having fun. And this has just come out. And on closer inspection, it's got stuff around the outside there. Look, that... I can't tell whether or not that's right in through the viewfinder, but no idea at all. No idea. But yeah, this ground throws out all kinds of strange and wonderful things. It's got texture like a thimble, so I don't know. I haven't got a clue what it is. If anyone knows, please let me know. Cool, on to the next. Still finding really unusual things, and really not sure what that is, but the shame the mouth had fallen out. There's a really good imprint there. It looks like a fryer, you know, like a fryer tuck or a, you know, it's hard to tell really. But yeah, I'm not gonna miss that. I'll tape it together, so to speak. But anyway, nice one. Onwards and upwards.